everything about the laws of physics that you studied in high school might turn out to be completely useless if you were to fall through this terrifying part of the universe. Yes, we are talking about the black hole. You might have come across the term black holes, but do you really know what they are and how daunting they can be? The black hole is an enigmatic part of the universe that can swallow and destroy everything that comes into contact with it. Not even light can find a way to escape. If that caught your attention, you need to stick till the end to know more about the biggest, most terrifying black hole in the known universe. Let's start by understanding what makes black holes unique. Well, black holes are regions in space where gravity is so strong that nothing can actually escape. It is the powerful gravitational pull that allows black holes to rip entire planets and stars apart. It all begins with the process of the formation of a black hole when stars with more than 20 solar masses exhaust the nuclear fuel at their core and collapse under their own weight. This collapse will then trigger a supernova explosion that will blow off the star's outer layers and will spread outward, thereby destroying everything in its path. Black holes are so powerful that they absorb every object that comes near the area of its influence. There is a black hole near Earth, and this one might be 3 to 12 times the sun's mass that is spread throughout our Milky Way galaxy. There's a lot more to a black hole apart from the scary part, of course. Don't let the name fool you that a black hole is an empty space. In fact, there is a great amount of matter inside that is packed into a very small area. But since the gravitational field is so strong, even light cannot escape from it, black holes are actually invisible. Only space telescopes with special tools can help us find them. If you think black holes are new, well, that is not the case, because let's say that if the current scientific theories are right about black holes, then they have been a part of our universe ever since the universe was about 1 billion years old. These black holes might have acquired more mass throughout their age by feeding on so many planets and stars, or maybe even merging with another black hole to form one larger body. But we need to keep in mind that these mergers are very rare, because even black holes are not so common in the universe for such mergers to happen very often. So, our best way to understand the black holes might be by studying the process of feeding and merging, which might then explain how the early black holes grew into the supermassive giants that we know today. Speaking of supermassive black holes, are you ready to discover the biggest, most terrifying one? Yes! The biggest and scariest black hole is the TON 618, which is about 18.2 billion light years away from our own planet. This one happens to be an ultra-massive black hole in the constellation Canes Venatici. The TON 618 by far happens to be the largest black hole in the known universe. It is so large that this black hole is the reason why we have a new classification of black holes, called the ultra-massive black holes. The extremely high gravitational pull of the TON 618 could be a result of its mass that might have been formed by merging of more than one black hole in the past, which in itself is a very rare event. The TON 618 is continuing to grow faster than ever before, and this black hole's mass is also about 8,000 times bigger than the black hole in the center of our own galaxy, which is the Milky Way galaxy, according to the astronomer Christopher Onken of Australian National University in Australia. To put things into perspective, if our own Milky Way's black hole was the size of TON 618, it would have to swallow 2/3 of all the stars in our own galaxy. But not all black holes are this massive, which means there will be several classifications for black holes. They can be stellar, intermediate, supermassive, or tiny. The smallest black hole we ever discovered is just over 3 times the mass of the sun. But then, you might be thinking, if black holes are completely invisible, how exactly did scientists and astronomers discover them? Well, it's true that black holes cannot be seen because of the strong gravitational pull that these cosmic giants possess, because of which even light does not escape and gets pulled into the black hole's center. So, the best way for scientists to study the black hole would be by observing the effects of its strong gravity on the stars and gases around it. By observing the star's orbit at a certain point in space, scientists will be able to study the star's motion to find out if it is orbiting a black hole and whether the star that is being observed is orbiting close together with the black hole. If that happens, there will be a presence of high-energy light, and scientific instruments can be used to observe this high-energy light. But not everything is scary about the black hole, which means we have some positive news for you. Black holes are not everywhere in the universe where they randomly absorb all the planets and stars. They do follow the laws of gravity, just like other objects in space, and if you think about whether our own planet will be absorbed into a black hole, well, the orbit of a black hole has to be very close to the solar system, which at this point is highly unlikely. Even if a black hole with the same mass as the Sun is near our Earth, our planet will still not fall into it and will still orbit the black hole as they orbit the Sun now. Black holes are quite strange because our solar system's outer planets orbit roughly every 250 years, while these huge objects in our cosmos rotate once every 3 months, traveling half the speed of light on its outer edge, according to several sources. The discovery of such a huge black hole, like the TUN 618, might challenge everything we know about our universe and our existing cosmological models, because we know that the formation of any objects like the TUN 618 would take a lot of time. This black hole might even hold many clues about the formation and the early phases of our own universe. So, when it comes to our universe, size might not be the only thing that matters, and we have a lot more to learn about the black holes because the laws of physics simply don't work in the black hole, which is why we cannot understand the interior of a black hole. Black holes can be millions of times larger than the suns and planets, or it can be as small as an atom. It all depends upon the density of mass inside it. Maybe the James Webb Telescope, just like the Hubble Telescope, will be able to provide more information about black holes, which is why the James Webb Space Telescope might be a true successor to the Hubble Space Telescope. Understanding what the universe is all about is the only way to uncover the mysteries of these scary objects of our cosmos, considering the fact that dark matter roughly makes up about 4/5 of the matter in the universe. According to Stephen Hawking, black holes are slowly evaporating, and maybe, in the far future of the universe, long after every star is dead and galaxies are completely stretched out because of the accelerating cosmic expansion, black holes might be the last surviving objects. But massive black holes, like the TUN 618, might take a huge number of years to evaporate, which means that black holes can be almost eternal. We still have so many mysteries to uncover when it comes to our knowledge about the universe. But one thing's for sure, you definitely don't want to fall into a black hole, because they will tear you apart and show no mercy. No material, especially fleshy human bodies, could survive intact. So, once you pass beyond the edge of the event horizon, you're done. There's no getting out.